The rapid testing kits distributed to various states in India by the centre will have to be validated first before they can be put to use. That's what the Indian Council of Medical Research has said. Now, this after one state complained about the quality issues. Now, states have been advised by the ICMR not to use these kits for the next 2 days. The ICMR will be in the meantime verifying the quality of these kits. Meanwhile, the Rajasthan government has announced that it will not be using the rapid test kits that it's received from China. As per the state government, the kits showed only an accuracy of around 5.4 in testing COVID-19 patients. We are being joined by our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibal, for more on this story. Good evening to you, Siddhant. Why is the accuracy of these tests that have been received from China so low?
Well, it is sensitivity, but it's also deja vu. We know that there have been countries like Spain who have been returning Chinese testing kits primarily because they are not sensitive enough to detect whether the person is COVID positive or not. So here in India, two states, West Bengal and the state of Rajasthan, had said that when it comes to Chinese testing kits, which India had got from three Chinese companies on 16th of April, they are not showing the required test. They are not sensitive enough, and the percentage varies from 5.4 to 9. And this is a matter which has been taken up with ICMR. And ICMR today, in the daily briefing of the government of India, officially announced that for 2 days these testing kits will not be used, and the ICMR will be sending its own personnel to the field to test the issues. And it is all said and done that it is going to be taken up with the government. With the companies in China from where the Indian government had procured these tests. But also we know that the Indian envoy to China has spoken exclusively with Vyond, in which he has extensively talked about what is India procuring from China. He said the main aim is to find bona fide supplier, and for this the Indian government is in touch with the Chinese government. We know when the story first broke last week about the donations which the Chinese NGOs had given to India, about their failure, that was a matter which was raised as well in the daily briefing. Back then we saw the Chinese embassy coming out with a strong response, saying that the authorities here in India should only get supplies from companies who have been approved by Chinese regulators. But this time this was clearly looked into by the Indian mission, but even then these tests have failed.
Siddhant, thank you for that report. That's our diplomatic correspondent Siddhant Sibal coming to us with the latest on these faulty testing kits from China.